A bearded man wears an open-collared check blue shirt under a navy suit jacket and a cochlear implant in one ear. Later, he holds a book called Culture is Inclusion, which has First Nation artwork on the cover.
Wiyabu, which is hello in my native language of Kutang. I'm Dr. Scott Avery. I'm very proud and humbled to be an ambassador for International Day of People with Disability 2023. I'm a Warramai man, which is in New South Wales. I'm also deaf, so I have to say I'm proud times too. Proud of my Warramai heritage, but also proud of being a deaf person. I've got a lovely wife with two daughters. I teach both Indigenous studies and Indigenous disability at universities across Australia. We're very proud of the publication Culture's Inclusion. The artwork is by an Aboriginal artist with disability whose name Uncle Paul Calcott, Yin Yamara, and actually tells the story of disability. So this came from me going out to the First Nations disability community and asking people, tell us your story. And I think this is very much an untold story in Australia. People are discovering it, not just for the book it is, but for the stories that are in it. When the invitation to be an ambassador of International Day of People with Disability is actually quite humbling. And I think the best way for me to talk about inclusion, I need to actually send your minds back 25,000 years. Out in Lake Mungo in Western New South Wales, there's these footprints in the clay. And amongst those footprints, there's this single right line of footprint. And the archaeologists went, what's going on here? So they asked the Aboriginal elders, and they said, that's a one-legged man on a hunt. And they're with community. They're participating in community life. And this idea of, look, we take all comers. This is what inclusion means, and this is how the world means it to be. There has been times where I have really struggled with it, and it's this idea of you suffer. I don't suffer hearing loss. It's my natural world. I'm okay with it. I know in some parts of the education system, there would be a 14-year-old Aboriginal child who's being told, you can't cut it. And I'm going, they're wrong, you can.
The International Day of People with Disability logo and website appear. idpwd.com.au